gamers, and welcome to one more board game show. In today's episode, we're going to be cracking open the 6th expansion from the Dunwich Cycle for Arkham Horror, the card game. So without further ado, let's crack it open and see what's in this box. All right, so first up, we've got our new explanations for rules and our campaign log. No new rules or anything like that in this one, I don't believe. There's some locations that were shuffled into the encounter deck. That's about it. So let's have a look at what is inside Lost in Time and Space. So as per usual, I will not show you the encounter deck stuff. So your monsters and your locations and stuff. Don't want to ruin that things for you. That's always fun to find out on yourself. So we're just going to show you these bad boys first. So first up for your blues, we have Vicious Blow. It's a skill level 2. If this skill test is successful during an attack, that attack deals plus 1 damage, plus 2 instead if it succeeds by 2 or more. Then our second blue card, it's cost of 1, it's an event, it's level 5. Monster Slayer, fight. If this attack succeeds against a non-elite enemy, defeat that enemy. And then we've got a level 5 asset, cost of 6. Called the Lightning Gun, uses 3 ammo. Spend 1 ammo, fight. You may get plus 5 punch for this attack. This attack deals plus 2 damage. It's a two-hander. So next we're up to the oranges, and we've got an ally. It's an asset, cost of 1, level 0, Dr. William T. Malison. When you draw an encounter card, exhaust Dr. William T. Malison and place one of your clues on your location. Cancel the drawing of that card and shuffle it back into your encounter deck, then draw a new card from the top of the encounter deck. He's got a Stemmer of 2 and Sanity of 2. Then next up, guys, we've got a level 5 asset, cost of 4, Deciphered Reality, investigate. The difficulty of this skill test is equal to the highest shroud value among revealed locations in play. If you succeed, discover one clue from each revealed location in play. Then we're on to our greens. So first up, we've got a level 4 asset, cost of 5, Chicago Typewriter, uses 4 ammo, spend 1 ammo, fight. You may spend any number of additional actions when you perform this attack. You get plus 2 punch for this attack for each action being spent. Including this ability cost, this attack deals plus 2 damage. Then we've got a asset with level 4, cost of 2, the Golden Pocket Watch, exceptional. When a phase begins, remove the Gold Pocket Watch from the game, skip this phase. After a phase ends, remove the Gold Pocket Watch from the game, repeat that phase. That could be an extremely handy little card right there. Asset, level 5, cost of 3, Shriveling, uses 4 charges, spend 1 charge, fight. This attack uses head instead of fist. You get plus 3 head and deal plus 2 damage for this attack. If any of the symbols is revealed during the attack, take 2 horror. Then we've got an level 5 event, cost of 1, Ward of Protection, fast. Play when you draw a non-weakness encounter card, cancel all that card's effects and discard it, then take 1 horror. Okay, so onto our reds now. We have a level 3 asset, cost of 4, Anquina. When an enemy attacks you, exhaust Anquina and deal 1 horror to her. Deal that enemy's damage to any enemy at your location instead. You still take horror dealt by the attack. Stamina of 1, Sanity of 4. Then we have a level 3 asset, cost of 2, try and try again. After a skill test is failed, if a skill card you own is committed to that test, exhaust, try and try again, return that skill card to your hand. Now we're onto our colorless cards. It is an asset, level 5, cost of 2, the Red Gloved Man, fast. After the Red Gloved Man enters play, choose 2 of your skills. While the Red Gloved Man is in play, raise the base value of each of those skills to 6, forced. At the end of the Mythos phase, discard the Red Gloved Man. Stamina of 4 and Sanity of 4. Okay guys, that's it. As I said before, I'm not going to show you with the locations and the encounters and stuff like that. I want them to be a surprise for you when you open it up. So thank you very much for watching, guys. Make sure to like, subscribe and share. And if you have anything you'd like us to watch, please put it in the comments below and we'll put that out there. So thank you again, guys, and we'll see you next time.